Hi students, coming to the next concept in the threads, that is the multi-threading models. So there are three different types of multi-threading models. So one is many to one, one to one, and many to many models. So these are the three different type of models, multi-threading models. Multi-threading models. Let us discuss one by one. So the first one I am taking here is the many to one. So what does many to one? The many to one here talking about many user level, many starting one, this is the user level, many user level threads maps to one, that is the single kernel thread. So that is the meaning of this many to one. Many to one means many user level threads maps to single kernel thread. So here only one thread can access the kernel at a time. Only one thread, even though they are having the many user level threads are there, only many user, but it can accept only one thread can access the kernel at a time. So multiple threading are unable to run in parallel on multiprocessor. So that is some one disadvantage in using the many to one concept. So let us, the examples for this many to one are examples are solar. Solar is green thread. And one more example is the GNU portable. GNU portable thread. So these two types of threads are follows the many to one threading model. So let me just give the how this many to one will be diagrammatic representation. Suppose this is a user level, you have taken user space. User space you are taking, suppose the process one and the process two. So user level, many user levels, that is multiple threads, many user levels, P1 and the P2. So each having their thread library. Each process is having one thread library. So each thread shares that library functions. Now coming to the kernel space. Kernel space. So here in kernel space, this is many to one. So at a time only one thread can access by the kernel. At a time only one thread can be accessed by kernel, and that can be executed in CPU, multiple CPUs. So this is a concept of many to one. Okay, so many process one and the process two, many threads are coming and only one kernel will be executing one thread at a time. So multiple threading are unable to run in parallel on multiple processors. Okay. Means another way you can represent. So let us take these all the user threads. So these user threads, these many user threads will use only one kernel thread. So these many to one, many user threads are communicate with only one kernel thread, many to one concept. Now coming to the next concept, that is one to one. One to one model. So the name itself saying that here only one user, each user level thread maps to one kernel thread. User to kernel. So the examples for this is Windows NT or XP or 2000. So all these operating systems will follow from one to one model, one user and one kernel. And the same way the Linux means it can also support one to one. It may support one to many also and many to one, but here one to one, these operating systems also support one to one concept. Linux, Solaris 9 and later versions also. Okay, so one to one means only one user and one kernel. So one user thread and one kernel thread. So each is one user, one kernel, one user, one kernel, like that. So if you take the user space, suppose if you take two processes P1 and P2, and this P1 and P2 are giving only one thread, one to one. So each having their library functions. And kernel space. So in the kernel space, this will be communicated with the kernel. Okay, so one at a time. So how many, based on the threads are coming, here it is communicating and executing in the CPU. So this is about one to one. So let me explain one to many to many also. So how that many to many will be executed. Many to many model. So many to many means here they are saying that it allows many user level threads to be mapped to many kernel levels, So here the it allows the operating system to create a sufficient number of kernel threads also. And the examples for Solaris prior to version 9 like that. So here these are the many threads